Alright, in this video, I wanna show you how to read consistent and get less punished for your attacks. This won't be a Facebook guide, so you have to put actual work into it. I just give you the tools. Most guides are designed to give you quick results, like combos. Basically, you watch, you execute, and you feel like you progress. I call it fake improvement, and I'll show you why. You hit your string sometimes, and sometimes not, and that's not very consistent. Without intentions, your chance of hitting your opponent is very low. Your opponent can dodge in 8 directions. He can spot dodge, he can attack, he can jump, and he can do nothing. So some games you feel really good because you hit your swings, and sometimes you feel like the worst player in Brawl because you hit nothing at all. But, so, there are things you don't know that you don't know about, right? This is really important to understand. That's the reason why most people believe that swings and combos are everything. Even in some pro guides, and this is so wrong. Combos and swings are 1% of the game. Think about it. Like, you have neutral game, map control, spacing, micro spacing, fighting game theory, and so on. There's so much stuff you should learn instead of combos. First, we have to understand what a read actually is. So, what do you guys think a read is? A read is when you know what your opponent will do next. You are 100% sure. Think about it. This is really important to understand. It's about your intentions. If you just attack without thinking, or you just wanna go for your swings, then it's a guess. Even if you hit your opponent correct, this is not a read, because your intentions were off. So we have a guess, then an educated guess, for example, your opponent likes to dodge away, like being defensive, and you kinda read in that general direction. And then we have a read, when you are 100% sure what he will do next. Example, he always panic jump off stage, and you know that. That's why in the early game, it's probably better to play safe. So you can see, reading is extremely hard when your opponent has so many options. So that's why you don't always go for a read. So, what can we do instead? Positional swings. Basically, you follow up your attacks with movement, or you react to your opponent, or both. And your goal is either to get a hit, or you don't get hit, and gain map control. You use your position to get an advantage, and you want to create a win-win situation. So, you want to keep your position in mind, and how you move. Now I will show you some examples and explain it. First, it looked like this. I get punished a lot. Now I do this instead. I attack, I move, and I react. You move with your attack into a better position. It's good because either you hit your opponent or you get a free edge guard. Again, I attack, I move towards the middle, and I react. This is a reaction, so I won't get punished. When you attack your opponent, you wanna react to dodges towards you. Because if he doesn't dodge towards you, he will be most likely in the air. And then all you have to do is to catch his landing. Same here, spot dodge reactable. Two things. One, he will dodge towards me, punish. If he doesn't, then he will be offstage. So it's a win-win situation and a free edge guard if he dodge to the left side. Attack, reposition, attack, reposition. If he's moving into me or dodging towards me, he gets punished. If he doesn't, I get map control. I react to in dodges. If I notice he doesn't dodge in, I catch instantly his landing. Same thing here. And see what will happen when I miss. You won't get punished. And now you can mix this up and go for actual reads. Exactly the same thing applies offstage. I don't care what Scarlett's doing, because if she's jumping up and goes towards the stage, she will get hit. And if she doesn't, I will get, again, a free edge guard. Attacking and then moving while attacking into a safe position.